हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लर्न विद निखिल। सो हियर वी हैव टेकन एन अनदर सम ऑन सेक्शनल ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन। सो फर्स्ट वी विल कैलकुलेट द टोटल विड्थ रिक्वायर्ड टू ड्रॉ द फ्रंट व्यू वुड बी 36 प्लस 64 प्लस 36 दैट इज 137 एंड इन द साइड व्यू द टोटल विड्थ रिक्वायर विल बी 54 प्लस 34 प्लस द रेडियस दैट इज 20 दैट विल बी 108 मिलीमीटर। So the total width required will be 137 plus 108. So according to that, you have to leave the space, the width space. Next, the total height required to draw the figure will be in the front view. It will be 80 plus radius 32. That would be 112 millimeters. Now first, we'll start drawing the sum with the axis that is XY. And x dash y dash axis, then 5 millimeter apart the baselines where we will draw the views. Now to start with the front view, this side will be the front view. So the width will start marking first 36 millimeter. So this distance is 36. After that, from 36, 64 millimeter. This is 64 millimeter point. Then from 64, again a distance of 36 millimeter. So this gives total 137 millimeter. Next we will mark the height of 54 millimeter. So this distance is 54 millimeter and above that the center point is 80 millimeter. So from the bottom 80 millimeter above, so this point will be the center point where we will draw the circles. I will draw a parallel line through these points. Next, I will mark the center point of this 64 width. So center point will be 32. So this is the 32 point. Through that point also, I'll draw the perpendicular straight line or parallel to this line. So this is the center axis line of the circle. So I'll draw it dotted. That will be big gap, small dash, gap, big line. This is the center axis line. Now 80 millimeter above and 54 millimeter above, we have marked the points. Through those points I'll draw this lines, parallel lines. Again the center axis line circle. This intersection at the center, from that we will draw the circles. So first circle, the outermost circle with radius of 32 is given. So on compass I have taken a radius of 32. Keep it here at the center. The above part of the circle will be dark and the lower part is hidden behind. So I am drawing it dotted as given in the question itself. We have to draw the normal front view, not the sectional. We have to draw the sectional side view. So front view we have to draw it as it is. Next, in a circle, the diameter given is 40, so radius of 20, I'll draw the circle. And then the innermost circle, the diameter given is 24, it is given in the side view, so radius of 12 millimeter on the compass, with same center, I'll draw the innermost circle. So this is the circle with diameter 24. Next, I'll draw projection lines from these ends of the circle. I'll take the projections downward towards the top view. As in the question, we have to draw the top view, sectional left view, and the front view. Next, the radius of the curve given is 26. So on compass, I'll take a distance of 26 mm. First, we have to locate the center point. So from here, keeping the pointer here, I'll cut an arc, small arc on this line. So this distance will be 26. Then keeping the compass pointer on this point, and we'll draw the arc or a curve. Not to draw the whole curve, whole circle, we have to draw a tangent to this 54 millimeter line. So this point height is 54 millimeter. I'll draw a light line here and extend it towards the side view also. Later on we'll require that. From here also I'll cut an arc of the distance 26, then keeping the pointer here, I'll draw a curve. This curve is of radius 26 millimeter. I'll draw a dark line here also. As given in the question, extend these lines dark. Joining this dark. Now next, I'll mark the center point 18 millimeter as the width is 36. So center point will be 18 millimeter. Also the dimension is given. From left side the distance is 18 millimeter, which is the center of 36. That will be the center point of the circle. So I'll draw a parallel line. As we want to draw these two circles, two holes of diameter 20. I'll mark the center point of 54 also, that will be 27. I'll draw a parallel line through that. So this will be the center point from where I'll draw two circles with diameter of 20. A diameter 20 is given, so radius of 10 millimeter. Keep the pointer at this point and draw the circle. So this is the first circle, diameter 20. Then this is the second circle of diameter 20. I'll draw the projections from the ends of this circle downward towards the top view. Next, as per given in the question, this line is dark. Same, this line is dark. Now from the center, the radius given is 20. So from the center, 20 above and 20 below. I've marked the points. Then I'll extend a line. As there are two semicircles with radius 20 given, it is given in the side view. So from that you get the dimension. Thickness is 16. It is given. So this thickness is 16. And the total height or the diameter of the semicircle is 40. So from the center, 20 above and 20 below, we have marked the points and drawn this. Now again a smaller circle is there with diameter 20. So from the center, 10 above and 10 below, we'll mark the point. And same as we did with the semicircle, we'll do for this circle. Now this circle is hidden, so I'm drawing dotted lines. extending this line towards the side view also. Now we are totally done with the front view. Now we have to draw the sectional side view. So according to that, we'll move forward. First, this distance of 18 I'll mark. Then after 18, the distance of 22. Then the distance of 14 millimeter. Then the distance of 34 millimeter. Then the radius of the semicircle, which is 20. So the distance of 20. So this is the total width for the side view. Now I'll draw parallel lines through them. Next, I'll make this line dark as given in the question. We have to draw the sectional side view. So this line will be visible after the section. The section is from the AA line, as you can see in the front view. I'm taking this circle projection towards the side view. This end points of the circle. So we don't have to take the dimension in the side view. You can directly draw it. So take all these points projection towards the side view. This part will be dark after the section. This circle will be visible after the section. This edges will be visible, so I am drawing it dark. This line will be light and dotted. I have drawn it dark. This will be light and dotted. I later change it. Now this semicircle of radius 20. So I've drawn the semicircle here. This is of radius 20. Then the inner circle of radius 10. So you can take the dimension here from directly. It's the projection. Draw the circle. Join the lines. So this whole section will be visible after the sectioned part, after the cut part. This part will also be dark. Now this is the width of the circle, which is given is 8 millimeter. So I've marked the distance of 8 millimeter. Width is 8 and height projection is already taken from the front view. So I'll extend it till here. So this is the thickness. Draw the center line. Now this part in the question, it is given dark, but this will be hidden after the section, as the section is cut from the center. This is the front side. This will go in the back side. So this is the back side as it is symmetry. Now taking the projection of this circle end towards the side view, Now this curve part projection is also been taken. This is not given in the question. That's the mistake in the question. So this curve part projection we have taken, and it will be extended upwards towards the circle as it holds the circle. That will part will be also dotted. So this is the curve part. From the side view, it looks straight. So till here, it holds the circle. Drawing the center axis line to the circle. This two circles will also be hidden. One circle will be out already. Only this circle, the behind circle, will be hidden. After the section, the left side circle is cut out. So it is not there only. But the right side circle will be hidden. So drawing it dotted. For the sectioned part, I'm taking this angle of 45 degree and drawing hash lines wherever the cut part is there or the sectioned part is there. So this figure is totally cut from the center, which is given in the front view. So I'm drawing this sectioned lines. It will be extended here also. Only this two circle part will be open and the semicircle part. So this is the sectioned part. This line will be dotted. This is the edge of the circle. Now for drawing the top view, first we will draw a 45 degree angle line. Take all the projections from the front view towards the top view and from the side view to the 45 degree angle line and from the 45 degree angle line towards the top view. Now for drawing the top view will be from here. The first part visible will be this circle. The circle will look like a rectangle from the top view. So width, this distance, the projection is from the front view. And the height distance, the projection is from the side view. So this is the distance, this is the diameter of the circle, that is 64. Height we have projected from the side view. So it will look like a rectangle from the top view, and it will be the first which will be visible from the top view. We have drawn a rectangle. Now this inner circles, so it is drilled. I'll take the projections till this part. It is drilled, the innermost smaller circle. Take the projections from the remaining points. So the circle will be hidden. So it will start from this and it will end till here. So I'll draw the dotted lines till this part only. From both the sides, both the edges of the circle. And the other circle is also there. Its thickness is 8 mm only. That will also be hidden. So I'm drawing it dotted. drawing the circle center axis line. Now this curved part will be a straight line from the top view. So its thickness will be from the front view. So this is the thickness and the height we have taken from the side view. It is on both the sides. So I am drawing the dark line on both the sides. This part is also dark. Now next, this is the backside part which is also visible in the top view. I've drawn it dark. Now this circle, the center axis line, and this circle, both the circles are hidden, so I'll draw them dotted. This circle and also this circle is hidden. Now next, this semicircle part, this part, it is double. So you can see from the front view, these are two. So they are extended from the top view. The semicircle part will look straight like a rectangle shape. And there are two like that. So this is one part. And this is the other part. So as you can see, the semicircle from the side view only looks one as it is overlapped. You can see from the top view there are two parts. I'll draw the center line here. As the circle is hidden, I'll draw it dotted. So on both the sides the circle is hidden. It is visible only from the side view. It is hidden in the top and the front view. I'll just mark the dimensions. Watch the video till the end as I'll tell you some missing parts which I have left. So I'll tell you at the end. So here this part, as you see, you have to remove it as it is sectioned. This part, this line will not be there. And we are done with the sum. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel. If you have any doubts, any queries, let me know in the comment section. You can also connect with me on Instagram.